A healthy community makes a healthy body and also makes a healthy country. The government of Uganda should look at this COVID, and it should be a self-awakening that COVID has led to violations, especially in increasing gender-based violence. The government of Uganda should know that the survivors of gender-based violence are more affected by issues of trauma because of access to justice, but also because of lack of self-help and self-care and rehabilitation. So we are calling upon the government of Uganda to put mental health and psychosocial support at the center of the healthy continuum of services. They should invest more in resourcing and giving more human resource in the hospitals that are taking care of health and mental care. They should provide for skilling money. They should provide for more money to investigate cases in a timeliness. They should invest in all those aspects that are helping the victims and survivors to recover, in addition to the perpetrators, to prevent gender-based violence. If already you are a vulnerable woman, and then you end up being a vulnerable person with disability, you cannot move faster. Some of them are on the streets. You are given birth through defilement, through rape. You cannot even pursue justice as a defilable person with disability because you don't even know how to move to the police. Even when you reach police, they are not going to listen. So they are more at a precarious position that we need to really look out for those most vulnerable amongst the vulnerable. Treating people with mental illness, and the problem is there are just very few. One person alone cannot run the whole clinic for mental illnesses. So this is something I call upon the district leaders, the district health officers, to ensure that they support the mental health workers they have in their community, in their districts, to be able to respond to people with mental health problems.
Okay, talk about that.